How's everybody doing this morning? Going playing some snow today. So, have you ever heard of anybody that's like 90 or 100 years old that's had a baby? No. Usually, what would you say would you think somebody, how old would they be to have a baby? What do you think? 28, yeah, probably. What do you think? 38? Thank you. Or even 40 or 42, yeah. Now, I was considered an old mother by having a baby at 42. But I don't look that old, do I? No, thanks. But can you imagine, I don't know, I don't think there's anybody out here that's over 90. Is there anybody? So, nobody, huh? So that's pretty old. That would seem almost impossible, right? That they would have a baby? Now, do you think that God can make that happen, though? Yes. And in the story we're going to hear in just a little bit, read by Sandy, you listen closely, because Abraham and Sarah, God promised them that they would have a baby and that they would have tons and tons and tons of descendants. And they were that old. And they did. It seemed impossible, but they did. So now when we look at the cross, our cross is kind of lit up here, or there's other crosses around. Now the cross, back in the time when Jesus was on earth, was not a beautiful thing. It was something that they used to torture people, to make people hurt and even die. And we know what happened to Jesus on the cross, right? Yep, he died on the cross. And it seems like almost impossible that something like that would give us, be a symbol of hope for us, right? Does that make sense? That something that's kind of really ugly would actually be something possible to bring us hope? But it did. We know that Jesus died on that cross and he saved us. And today we look at the cross as a symbol and a sign of promise and hope. And there's something else that we usually think of at Easter that also brings us a sign of hope. We think of butterflies. Do you ever think of butterflies as like a sign of life and hope? Yeah. And so that's one of the things we're going to have you do during Lent, is we want you to make a butterfly for us. And I actually have a kit for you. And then I want you to bring it back here in a couple weeks or less. Okay? And we're going to use them at Easter Vigil, so you can come back and see what we use them for. But as you're working on your butterfly, I want you to think of things that seem impossible, that God makes possible, and how God does some pretty amazing stuff in our life. So I want you to think about that, and then I'm going to have you actually take a few butterfly kits, and you can pass them out to other people out there that's not in your family, so feel free to target another family that maybe didn't have a kid up here, that they could take one home with them too. And if you didn't get one, there's more at the back in the narthex. You can take one home. So, should we pray first, and then we'll help you. Dear God, thank you for bringing beauty out of ugly things, for making things possible out of the impossible. We love you. Amen. So maybe Pastor Mark or the acolytes could help. So feel free to take a few kits and pass some out to some people that didn't have kids up here. And make sure you keep one for yourself, okay? Take an extra, but we got one.